23절 말씀부터 20절까지
verses 13 through 20.
예수께서 빌립보 가이사라 지방에 이르러 제자들에게 물어 이르시되 사람들이 인자를 누구라 하느냐?
And they say, some say John the Baptist, others say Elijah, and others Jeremiah or one of the prophets.
이르시되 너희는 나를 누구라 하느냐?
Simon Peter replied, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God.
예수께서 대답하여 이르시되 바요나 시모나 네가 복이 있도다 이를 내게 알게 한 이는 혈육이 아니요 하늘에 계신 내 아버지시니라.
And I tell you, you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it.
내가 천국 열쇠를 내게 주리니 네가 땅에서 무엇이든지 매면 하늘에서도 매일 것이요 네가 땅에서 무엇이든지 풀면 하늘에서도 풀리리라 하시고.
Then he strictly charged the disciples to tell no one that he was the Christ. Amen. Let's bless each other, be at peace.
당신은 세계 살릴 선교사입니다.
You're the missionaries to save the world.
그 황무한 땅을 기업으로 상속하십시다.
Let us receive the inheritance of the desolate heritages.
오늘 또 하나님이 나에게 약속하신 그 은혜가 있습니다.
There is the grace that God has promised us today.
겸손함으로 주님 앞에 나아가는 믿음의 사람들 되기를 바랍니다.
I really hope that you guys become the people who are humble and go before God and awaiting the grace of God and seeing, looking towards the work that God will do inside of our field. And I bless you in the name of the Lord. May it be that blessed time today.
하나님께서 우리에게 주신 성경의 핵심은
The core of the Bible that God has given us is the gospel. God never gave us religion, but He gave us the gospel.
그래서 우리는 복음 안에서 내 삶이 나의 모든 것이 정리가 되어 있어야.
That is why we must be, our lives must be organized inside of the gospel.
내가 누구인가?
Who am I?
복음 안에서 그리스도 안에서 내가 정리 안 되어 있으면은
inside of the gospel, inside of Christ, if I am not organized, then we fall into trial.
그이가 남의 눈치 때문에 자기가 힘든 삶을 살아가는 거죠.
And many people are there just walking around eggshells, and because of that, they face hardship.
자기 자신이 정해놓은 법 때문에 거기에 얽매여 가지고 고통하는 것.
And you're able to see that many people, because of the rules that and the standards that set up, that they own set up, they fall into pain and suffering. But those who have the organization of their lives inside of the gospel, then they will receive strength and they're truly happy. And no matter what the circumstances or the environments are like, we are able to receive freedom. And that is why it tells us,
진리를 알지니 진리가 너희를 자유케 하리라 말씀했습니다.
Says you know the truth and the truth will set you free.
여러분 참된 행복이 있습니까?
Do you truly have true happiness?
여러분에게 있습니까?
Do you have true power?
참된 자유함이 여러분에게 있습니까?
Or do you have true freedom?
만약에 이 사실을 놓치고 있다면은 오늘 이 시간에
If you guys are losing hold of this fact, then at this time today,
정리되어지는 그런 축복의 시간들 되기를 주의 이름으로
축복합니다. I bless you in the name of the Lord. May it be the blessed time today where you truly go inside of those blessings.
그 복음의 핵심이 오늘 본문인 마태복음 16장 13절에서 20절에 말씀하고 있습니다.
And today it tells us in today's passage Matthew 16:13-20.
가장 중요한 메시지를 주님께서 제자들에게 물으셨습니다.
The most important message the Lord asked to the disciples. Who do people say that I am? Then who do you say that I am?
그 질문에 베드로가 고백했습니다.
And to that question Peter answers.
살아계신 하나님의 아들이십니다.
You are the Christ, the Son of the living God.
사실은 이 고백한 베드로에게 주님께서 말씀했습니다.
And to that Peter who confessed that faith,
Jesus replied,
아버지의
성령께서 너에게 그 그리스도를 알게 하셨구나라고 오늘 본문에 말씀하고 있습니다.
The Father through the Holy Spirit made you know who I am.
지금 내 눈앞에 서 있는 너와 함께 하신 이가 누구신지 하나님이 알게 하셨구나라는 사실들을 오늘 본문에 말씀하고 있는 것이죠.
That God made know to Peter who Jesus was.
그래서 17절에 말씀하고 있습니다.
And that is why if you see in verse 17 today.
시몬아 네가 복이 있도다 이를 내게 알게 하니는 혈육이 아니요 하늘에 계신 내 아버지시니라 했습니다.
Saying Jesus answered him, Blessed are you, Simon Bar-Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father who is in heaven. We are able to know that Jesus is Christ by grace. What does it mean by grace?
내가 뭔지도 모르는데 복음을 들을 때에 하나님께서 믿게 만들어서 구원 받게
We don't even know what
그게 은혜입니다.
The word is speaking of, but God lets us know the gospel and makes us believe. And to that Peter who confessed, Jesus blesses him, said, Blessed are you, Simon Bar-Jonah. What does it mean by you are the Christ, the Son of the living God? God promised us that he will send us the one that will solve all of our problems. And Lord, you are that Christ.
창세 전부터 예비한 그 어마어마한 비밀이 바로 그리스도 안에서 다 이루어졌다라는 사실을 말씀하고 있는 것이.
And he's telling us through Christ all of the things that were predestined has been fulfilled.
모든 것의 완성입니다.
And that is why Jesus Christ it means is the completion. And the solution to all of our problems.
얼마만큼 확인하느냐? 거기서 하나님의 역사들은 일어나게 되어 있는 것이.
How much do we confirm that Jesus is the Christ inside of our lives? That is when God works.
내게 부딪혀져 와야 하는 것입니다.
The meaning of Christ must strike our heart.
그때부터 하나님의 역사들은 일어나게 되어 있는 것입니다.
And at that time, the work of God arises.
그런 의미를 깨닫기 위해서는 첫 번째로 예수가
Then first, to know the meaning of Christ, we must first know that Jesus is the Christ.
그 안에 모든 것이 다 있습니다.
And inside of that is everything.
오늘 본문에 그렇게 말씀하고 있죠.
In today's passage, it tells us.
내가 내 교회를 세우리니 말씀했습니다.
He said, I will build my church upon your rock. What is the church? A church is a place, the house, where God resides, and it is the body of Christ. And that is why the more we realize Jesus is the Christ and pray, then God will make us, build us, and raise us up. If our lives are raised up on other things, And if my thoughts and my ideology are raised up, then that is bound to fall. And without God and the gospel, we can be successful and we can be sufficient with the things of the world. But absolutely, that is bound to fall. And that is the Tower of Babel and the Nephilim. And God told us, Jesus said, I will build my church. It means that the Lord will raise it up. My soul, my life, even my children's, the church, God, the Lord will raise it up. So what is the walk of faith? The walk of faith, it is not me or doing things with my things, but it is the Lord raising it up. The Lord must be in the place where I must be. And we must let ourselves rely on Christ so that the Lord could rule over us. And when the church is raised up, it tells us the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. When the church is raised up, then the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. And if myself does not become the church and does not become the place where Christ dwells in. And if I am the master of my own life, then the gates of hell will prevail against us. So you must remember, the gates of hell cannot prevail against the church. He cannot win over Christ. That is why I myself must become the church. And we must become the temple where Christ resides in. If I am in the place of myself, then the gates of hell will prevail against that. God is with us and said He will not leave us. And that is why there is only one problem inside of our life. It is forgetting and losing hold of that God is with me, and that is our one problem inside of our lives. So you must have assurance. The gates of hell shall not prevail against it. No matter what the case, we cannot fail. So don't fall into trial and don't fall into hardship, and really remember that gates of hell shall not, cannot prevail against us. The powerlessness that's inside of us cannot break us down. And even the spiritual problems that is inside of us cannot do anything with us. Non-believers, they fail because of the spiritual problems. But the spiritual problems of those who have received salvation, God uses that spiritual problem so that we can go inside of the gospel deeper. So we are, even though we might have problems, we are able to do the works of God. You must have the assurance that those who have received salvation, not even the gates of hell can prevail over that. And those who have received salvation and know the gospel, the problems of their families, their family lines, because of that, they are not hindered. They are able to know that the plan of God lies inside of that. You guys all know Crosby. Fanny Crosby, who wrote many praises, has left us the grace. She left behind over 6,000 praises.
불려지는 찬양이 바로 이 크로스비의 찬양이라고 나올 정도로 크로스비가 많은 영감을 가지고
And through worldwide people praise this praise that is written by Crosby.
근데 우리가 알고 있는 바 이 크로스비는 바로 자기를 키울 수 없는 생활을 해야 되니까 돈 벌러 나가는 그런 상황이었습니다.
Fanny Crosby, she her mother could not take care of her. So her grandmother had no choice but to take care of her. But without her wanting it, she became blind. And the mother who went out to earn money, she, once a week she would come and pray for her.
말씀, 성경에 대해서 읽고 듣도록 계속해서 신앙 교육을 한 것입니다.
And the grandmother, she would always read the Bible and
그 아이의 영혼 속에
teach her about the Bible.
세상에 대한 한보다는 하나님의 말씀 복음이 그 아이 영혼 속에 담겨지게 되었습니다.
That is why inside of the souls of Fanny Crosby, not the things of the world, but the things pertaining to God was filling her up. And that is why she wrote this praise, and now is being praised. And she gave this confession. It's rather better for me that I am blind. And she confessed that she will be blind. We all have complexes. And there's no one who boasts about that complex. And that is why we try to hide that from others. But you must truly remember, the gates of hell not shall not prevail against it. We must all know that our complexes that we want to hide, God will use that for His work. But that is why if you are not able to realize the gospel and enjoy the gospel, we are bound to be deceived by Satan. We all have these situations. And that is why we speak rationally about this or that. But if our life is not organized inside of the gospel, then our lives have no choice but to run the errands for the non-believers and follow after the world. Jesus said that He will build His church. And upon that church, the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. And He said He will give us the keys to the kingdom of heaven. Matthew, the book of Matthew is the book that was written towards the Jewish people. That is why we want to say the kingdom of God, but it says the kingdom of heaven. What does it mean, the kingdom of heaven? It means that He will give us the key to the kingdom of God. And the core of the kingdom of God, the meaning it has, is ruling. That is why whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. And God has given us all of the blessing where we can subdue and rule over all the land. God has entrusted His power to us. And through prayer, we're able to use those powers. So inside of Christ, we must be able to find that. Only through prayer can that happen. We're not doing the prayers where we're trying to snatch the things out of God's hands.
그래서 성령께서 알게 하시는 하나님의 축복과 비밀을 누리는 그것이 바로 기도라는 것입니다.
The blessing of realizing the mystery and the secret that God has and praying for that is enjoying Christ. Truly have holy meditation upon this. So I really hope that that time could be the time where you could give the confession like Peter. So, in history, what was the most powerful church? So, those who are organized with the gospel, they have gathered at the church. And with the mission that God has given them, they became oneness. And historically speaking, that was the most powerful church, and that was the church of Mark's Upper Room. All of the people who were in the Mark's Upper Room, they had the answer, and they were organized with the gospel, and they all had the mission that God has given them. And they were able to only go inside of prayer. The people who gathered in Mark's upper room, they gathered their hearts and went into only prayer. And nothing could break down the Mark's upper room. The idioms of the Jewish people could not break down the marks of Peru. The Romans could not break down the marks of Peru.
로마 속국되어 있는 그 로마의 막강한 힘을 가지고도 복음을 무너뜨리지 못했습니다.
And with the powers of that great Rome, could not break down the marks of Peru. The marks of Peru, they did not even have a temple, but they had the gospel, and they had the mission that God gave them. And they came in oneness, and no one could break down that church. And the blessing that the marks of Peru had was Christ. They held on to the covenant that Jesus is Christ, the solution to all of their problems, and that is how they started that church.
수천 년 전부터 왕과 제사장과 선지자를 보내시면서 예언한 그 그리스도, 그 언약을 가진 교회가 바로 마가 다락방 교회였다는
For thousands of years, the what was prophesied through the many kings, prophets, and the priests, and they were sent. God will send us the one, the Lord, who will solve all of the problem, and that was Christ.
우리가 충분하고 완전한 그리스도만 붙잡는 그런 교회로 남기를 주의 이름으로 축원합니다.
I really bless you in the name of the Lord. May our church be the church where we are sufficient and complete with only Christ.
그래서 갈수록 교회는 경건의 모습은 있지만은 능력은 부인한다라고 디모데후서 3장 5절에 말씀하고 있습니다. 마태복음 25장에도 보면은 결국은
That is why if you see in 2 Timothy 3:5 having appearance of godliness but denying its power avoid such people and these things will arise in the future and the antichrist will come arise and they will deceive many people in the end times
어렵고 위기 가운데 문제 가운데
That is why churches have no choice but to fall into more hardship and suffering later on. But there is a mystery to block all of that attacks of Satan. If you hold on to the mystery of Christ and be sufficient and complete inside of it, then through that church, God will save that age. Really prayed, may our church be the church where we only hold on to Christ. Jesus said, I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. And God, He promised us He will give us all of the power. I bless you in the name of the Lord. May our church be the church that will save this age. Second, the Lord said He has finished everything. But I'm still inside of that problem. I am not able to see the end.
하나님의 말씀은 다 이루었다 말씀하시는데 나는 여전히 문제 가운데 있습니다.
It says the word of God has completed everything, but I'm still inside of the problem.
이루었다는 것은 하나님의 말씀의 완전한 부분들을 우리가 믿어야 돼요.
We must really be able to believe the completion and the perfection of the word. But what still is the problem is just my current state.
말씀의 성취와 함께 나는 아직까지 그 부분이 끝나지 않았다는 사실에 그 사이에 대한 중요한 갭이 있어요.
So there is a gap between myself and the word that is complete.
우리가 하나님의 응답을 받을 수 있는 절호의 기회인 것입니다.
But that is the chance where we are able to receive the answers from God.
주님은 다 이루었다예요.
The Lord said He has finished everything, but I'm still not finished. But there is a gap between those two.
하나님의 응답을 받을 수 있는 그 사이의 갭은 하나님의 응답을 받을 수 있는
But that becomes a chance where we are able to receive all of the answers. So if you see in Mark chapter 9, he goes up into Mount of Transfiguration.
귀신들인 아이를 든 부모가 예수님 앞에 나오는 모습이 나옵니다.
And there is a demon, a mother of a demon possessed girl, and comes before Jesus.
귀신들린 아이를 든 부모가 예수님 앞에 달려 나온 것입니다.
So after Jesus was coming down from the Mount of Transfiguration, 그 the parents of the demon possessed a child comes before Jesus, and in the Bible it says that child was demon possessed from birth.
고쳐달라고 제자 앞에 데리고 나간 거예요.
And the disciple, the parents came before the disciples and say, "Please heal her." And but the disciples could not.
이를 둔 부모님이 예수님께 달려 나왔었죠.
That is why the parents of this demon possessed child came before Jesus, and Jesus says,
그때 9장 23절에 주님께서 말씀하고 계십니다.
And says to Jesus,
할 수 있거든이 무슨 말이냐?
Healer,
if you can,
and Jesus answers, and Jesus said to him, if you can, all things are possible for one who believes. And that is why the parent says, I believe. And says, I believe, help my unbelief.
자기들도 귀신을 내어줬던 경험이 있었거든요. 누가 보면 10장에 보면은
so if you see in Luke,
귀신을 쫓는 경험들을 제자들이 했었습니다.
In the book of Luke, you're able to see the disciples casting out demons.
17절에 주여 주의 이름으로 귀신들도 우리에게 항복하되이다. 제자들이 와서 보고했습니다.
And the disciples came to Jesus and gave the report that by your name even demons flee. And at that time, Jesus answers.
He
says, I have seen Satan fall from heaven to earth. So don't be overjoyed with that.
And
that is why, behold, I have given you the authority to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all of the power of the enemy, and nothing shall hurt you.
나온 것이죠. 왜 그때는 되었는데 지금은 안 되는가?
The disciples, they were able to cast out demons in the past, but why not now?
근데 거의 다가 자기 나름대로 여기에 포기하고 여기에 정지하고 하는 것입니다.
And now many of the people, many of the disciples, they gave up on that.
왜 안 됩니까?
Jesus Christ said he has finished everything, he has solved everything, but why hasn't it ended it for me?
물었습니다. 여러분 이게 신앙생활이에요. 여러분 안 되는 부분들을 가지고 감출 필요 없습니다. 주님 앞에 나와서 물으면 돼요.
And disciples went and asked Jesus, so that is the walk of faith. Don't be embarrassed about the things of your problems. Just come before God.
기도 외에 다른 것으로는 이런 종류가 나갈 수 없느니라 했습니다.
And that is when Jesus gives the answer, saying that only through prayer you're able to cast out demons.
여러분 그때부터 제자들에게는 기도라는 말의 의미가 다른 것이었습니다.
And that's when for the disciples, prayer became a totally different thing. What kind of heart do you think they had when they prayed?
복음 안에서 우리 인생이 정리되고 복음 안에서 하나님 주신 축복들을 나누는 그런 응답들이 있어야 되는 것입니다.
We must have the answer of really sharing of the word of God. So truly, with all of your weaknesses, just go before the Lord. Don't give up. Don't fall into discouragement. Go before the Lord. You're able to see that Jesus spoke of the works pertaining to the kingdom of God for 40 days. It is the resurrected Christ. He must have gone to heaven. But the Lord who resurrected for 40 days to the disciples spoke of the works pertaining to the kingdom of God. Just as I told you before, the core, the message, and the meaning of the kingdom of God is ruling.
다스리는 것 하나도 없지 않습니까?
God, He rules over everything, but I'm not able to rule over anything. We are always oppressed and we are ruled by others, and there is no freedom inside of our lives. With the problems that has not even arise yet, we are always falling into problem. And this is the proof that our kingdom of God inside of us is being stolen away.
나는 늘 세상과 환경과 내 문제에 고통 당하고 있습니다.
We're always facing suffering because of my environment, my thoughts, and inside of this gap, we must find, and that is the mission.
바로 천국에 가지 않고 40일 동안 하나님의 나라에 대한 부분들을 제자들에게 어떤 마음으로 전달했을까요?
So not going up to heaven right away. For 40 days, with what kind of heart do you think Jesus told the disciples? And same for the disciples, how do you think they received that word? The disciples totally imprint the word of the Lord inside of their hearts. And that is why they were able to go inside of prayer. They were able to go only inside of prayer.
바로 주님의 심령이 통하고 영이 통한 그런 마가 다락방의 자리였습니다.
It was a place where they were able to
자신의 모든 한계와 연약함과 부족함을 다 가지고 하나님의 나라에 대해서 40일 동안 들었습니다.
With their own problems and their situations, they were
나는 왜 안 되는가 거기에 대한 답을 딱 가진 것이죠.
They received the words pertaining to the kingdom of God. The Lord is able to do it, but I'm not able to. And inside of that, they were able to find the answer. And the disciples were able to go inside of that work of the kingdom of God. So as we live our lives, we must live with the power of the kingdom of God. And that is salvation, and that is the power of God. And that is why if you see in Acts 1:8, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you. Do we truly have the time where we are truly filled by the Holy Spirit?
We must
have the time where we every day find the answer and the power that is given from above so we can live on. And from there, we are able to go to the ends of the earth to become the witness. So that means that we must find the answer where we are able to only live by the power of God, God's kingdom.
우리 사이에 하나님과 우리 사이에 뭔가 지금 내가 안 되고 있는 부분들을 하나님의 응답을 찾아내는 미션으로 붙잡아라는 사실.
So really, hold on to this as your mission, the gap between the Lord and myself.
바울은 입만 열면은 하나님 앞에 찬양한다 했어.
I'll come to the end of my words. The Apostle Paul, whenever he opened his mouth, he will praise the Lord. He was faced with so much problem. But the confession that always came out of the mouth of Paul was praise. Paul confessed that he has received everything, even in the midst of all of these problems. And where was he able to come to that answer? When his life was organized, that is when that confession comes out. Inside of the gospel, all of our problems are solved. But it doesn't just end there. We find the answers of God inside of the problems that I still have.
우리의 그 어떤 환경 속에서도 감사가 나올 수밖에 없는 것이고요.
And there we are able to give thanksgiving in all of the circumstances. And we're able to come to the answer.
복음 안에서 내 인생이 정리되었다라는 것입니다.
And that's what it means that our life has been organized inside of the gospel. in 1 Corinthians 2:12, it tells us, now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit who is from God. Why did God give us the Spirit from God? It is so that we might understand the things freely given us by God. We have received so much grace. Inside of Christ, God has given us everything, so we're not envious of the world. God has given us the complete things and the perfect things and the sufficient things inside of Christ, but we are just not unaware of that. I bless you in the name of the Lord. May all of our believers of Hana Church really receive and organize the things of organize our lives inside of the gospel. So it is what's given to me. And the more we find that, we're able to see the works of the kingdom of God. I bless you in the name of the Lord. May all of your steps receive this kind of blessings.
Christo 2번은 하나님의 나라에 대한 부분들이고요. 3번은